Hello everyone, this is Crota giving you a not a shoutcast, but a review on the SteelSeries 6G V2 mechanical keyboard, and then going into keyboards in general and their switches and just their basic design. Now, a couple people had asked me what I had thought of mechanical keyboards and if I had any reviews or any thoughts or comments on them, and to be honest, I had never really tried using a mechanical keyboard. So I talked to SteelSeries, I met a couple representatives, and I said, you know what, I want to do some reviews, want to figure out what is the craze behind mechanical keyboards and what makes them better. So first of all, I'm going to go into the SteelSeries 6G V2. Thank you, SteelSeries, for sending me a sample. And then I will be talking a little bit more in-depth behind the switches, precisely in the standard Crota style that you guys all have come to love. Now, first thing I want to say is that the SteelSeries keyboard, it's small. After you guys have seen a lot of the other gaming keyboards out there that have macro switches and all the additional switches along the side, the SteelSeries sitting next to a Logitech G11, G15, feels very compact, and when you first look at it, you don't really know why it's a gaming keyboard. The switches is a real big indicator, and then when you look at the keyboard itself, you'll notice a couple key moments and a key items. First of all, the left window switch has been removed. If you take a look right here, that is actually a SteelSeries icon that is used in order to activate or deactivate, or use it kind of like a function key for all of these media keys right up here. So you see there's a mute, a volume down, volume up, play, fast, rewind, and fast forward. That's how you activate those switches. The reasoning behind this is because many times when you, as a player, if you're trying to use the alt keys and the control keys consistently, you may accidentally hit the Windows key, and then all of a sudden the Windows icon and the task manager shows up on the bottom left hand side. This is how SteelSeries handled it. They replaced it with a separate key. There is still a Windows key on the bottom right hand side, so that's still there, but for people like me who often use the Windows shortcut keys like Window D to go straight to a desktop, it does take a little bit to get used to, but otherwise most people will not notice it. Second thing, as a programmer and someone who actually types on my keyboard as well, another thing you'll notice is this giant return key and this enter key. This is a kickback to the old school days of the IBM DOS computers. My first computer, an IBM 8086, and you can see the size of that enter key. It is much larger, and it is the actual return. In order to make room for that switch, they ended up moving this switch from up here down to here. You're not going to notice that much of a difference unless you're used to using the shift button here and then the key next to it to make a question mark. Sometimes I do that in my programming, in my typing, and it's a little bit annoying, but it does take a little bit to get used to, but it's not that big of a deal breaker. Otherwise, the keyboard layout and the actual physical feel of the keyboard really bodes well for LAN tournaments. If you want to transport the keyboard, or anyone who's been to a LAN tournament, you know that compact is good. Shaving off 3 inches, making sure that there's no extras on the keyboard itself is very nice. It's very compact, but it's durable. And when I mean it's durable, if you pick it up, you're definitely going to know that there's a solid steel plating in there. It feels sturdy. There's no twisting or warping if you try to move it around. And also another thing that I really like about it is the traction and the anti-slip on the bottom of the SteelSeries keyboard. It really prevents it from moving around. So during those really high intense gaming sessions, where if you accidentally bump your keyboard, it's not going to really move it unless you physically really try to move it. Now, the 6G V2 uses cherry black switches, and you're going to hear this a lot in the mechanical keyboard sense. Cherry black, cherry brown, cherry blue. Like, what does this all mean? So I did a little bit of research, and I was able to find a couple websites out there that really explained it. And so I'm going to address and also give a little bit more insight as well. Here are the mechanical switches in the mechanical switches in the 6G V2. What you're going to see here is that the black switch here, and when you press down on it, its operating point is not at the very, very bottom of the key. And if for most keyboards that are dome keyboards, such as laptops and most cheaper generic keyboards, you once you bottom out the key, that's when you finally hit the switch. That's not true on a mechanical keyboard. What you're going to notice here is as you push this down, when this actually touches the other side here, that's when the switch is activated. And then you have a little bit more room, like about, 2 millimeters more before you bottom out the switch. So the way you really use mechanical keyboards is that your fingers kind of have to dance across the top of the keys. You don't want to bottom it out, because if you do start bottoming out, you'll feel that the mechanical black switches are really, really stiff. And your hands will actually get tired until you realize that you don't need to press the keys all the way down. Now, switching from a mechanical to a non-mechanical, it feels really strange. As when you try practicing on a mechanical keyboard, you're very conscious of not bottoming out the switch. And then when you go back to a dome, you have to bottom out the switch. And it feels very unnatural, and your fingers just don't dance across the top. Now, the real difference between the black switch and the red switch is the amount of force needed to activate the switch. The red switch, in this particular instance, actually takes a little bit less force than the black, but the overall design of the switch is the same. Now, the one downside about this is that you don't have any real tactical feedback on when the switch is activated. You just have to blindly know that the switch is activated. And for someone like me who's transitioning, things like typing in passwords, if you don't know if you hit the switch or not, you end up having to go back, delete everything, and trying it one more time. In order to solve that, Cherry, the MX company, also makes something called brown and white switches. What you're going to notice here is that there is a slight little bit of a tactical click that you'll feel as the switch hits. You'll see that there's a little bit of tactical feedback, and then it comes out with this really weird wavy operating chart where the amount of force needed and the distance traveled is different. So there's the pressure point here, there's the operating point. So once you hit that pressure point, it takes a little bit more force, your finger naturally gets to the operating point, and then this is the bottom out line here. There's also the reset point coming back, and that is how the brown and the white switches work. Just like black and red, the brown switch, I believe, is a little bit stiffer than the white switch in terms of the actual keys. Now, brown and white switches are not as common as cherry blacks. The second common other switch you'll see besides the cherry black is going to be the cherry blue. And the cherry blue switch itself looks and operates very, very differently. In addition to having a tactical feel, you'll actually hear an audible click as you're typing. And that audible click is supposed to indicate to you that the switch was actually hit. Now, it's good if you need that audible click and you need that feel in order to figure out if you're hitting the key. The bad thing is there is a loud click. Now, if you are by yourself, if you're a bachelor or you don't have a roommate and you don't work on papers late at night with a roommate sleeping, that's fine. But if your keyboard is in a public area where you generally want it to be quiet, that's probably not the best way to go. So there we go. There's the cherry blacks, cherry blues, cherry browns, cherry whites. I hope you guys enjoyed a little bit of this tutorial. Right now, I'm still reviewing the cherry black. If you guys have questions for me, go ahead and put them in the comments here. I'll give you my feedback. I've been told that the Steel Series cherry blacks are a little bit stiffer than, say, some of the other cherry blacks. Right now, I do not have any form of comparison, so I cannot confirm or deny that rumor. Hopefully, someone out there will send me another keyboard with cherry blacks, and I will be able to test that as well. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Hope you guys enjoyed this review of the SteelSeries 6G V2 and a little bit on the discussion on the switches that go behind it. If you guys out there are looking for a mechanical keyboard, does it really make that much of a difference? And I think mechanical keyboards in general have a better feel. And as you learn to use the mechanical keyboard better, it should improve your StarCraft II playing, just because you won't be wasting time trying to dance around or wasting energy. And because of that slight faster activation, who knows, maybe all those microseconds will add into a better 4-gate timing for you. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Hope to see you guys on Battle.net.